Now the vote, Wisconsin's future, a race for state assembly still undecided after a Democrat declares victory in a race that initially had a Republican winning. So what went wrong with the tally? Kristen Byrne in the newsroom in search of some answers. Kristen.
Steve, I do have the latest numbers here. In this District 14 race, at first, Democrat Robyn Vining was losing against her Republican opponent, Matt Adamczyk. But because of a problem in two wards, now those results are reversed.
Updated vote totals in Wauwatosa Wards 16 and 17 have changed the election outcome again. In state assembly race representing District 14, which covers part of Waukesha and Milwaukee counties. The discrepancy surprising to voters here.
It's crazy. I didn't realize there are that kind of issues around this area.
The new numbers push Democrat Robyn Vining 119 votes over her top Republican opponent, Matt Adamczyk. But in the first count, Adamczyk was up by 34 votes.
We discovered there was an error in Wauwatosa's result.
Julietta Henry with the Milwaukee County Election Commission explains it's investigating whether there was a problem with the modem inside a voting machine or if an election worker removed a flash drive with voting data on it too early.
Anything else you guys want to say to those candidates? One person thought they won this race.
Right. And again, the unofficial results, that's why they are called unofficial. We're in the process of certifying the election.
But Robyn Vining is declaring victory.
From what we were seeing, it wasn't adding up for us the way that it looked on the television. And so we didn't think it was over yet.
Adamczyk provided us with this statement. In part, it says, quote, "This new unofficial result discovery is the reason we have a canvass. I will wait until after the official canvass results to announce my decision, whether or not I pursue a recount."
I hope it doesn't happen again, because you definitely want to think that your vote counts.
And Wauwatosa City Clerk told me from now on at polling locations, workers will send absentee votes after the regular votes. The hope is that that will make this process smoother. In the newsroom, Kristen Byrne, today's TMJ4.
They call it unofficial for a reason. We get it now. Kristen, thanks.